My beautiful Biafran people, how will I day? Hope you are enjoying yourself. Yes, many things are happening. Many things are happening in the land of Biafra. Our restoration is very close. You see, one thing the Southeast leaders don't understand is that these Fulani people are only using them. When they are done with them, they will kick them out. You see, they have not realized what is going on yet, but we already saw it coming. You see, the issue of Ojikalu, okay, that's a very funny case, you know. It's very funny. If the court sacked him and demanded for another election in 90 days, that shows that the election that got him into the senatorial seat was illegal. Okay, let's say maybe there was vote buying, or maybe there was corruption, or maybe this is something they know. That's the reason why they sacked him. You see, barely 8 hours after he was sacked as the senator representing Abia North, you know, by the National and State Assembly election, you know, in Abia State, the former governor of the state, you know, have denied report making around that he sold the entire share capital of his banking group, you know, First International Bank Group Limited, the Gambian, you know, Kalu, he was one of the top leaders in the APC, you know. He was one of the top leaders in APC. You know, he was accused of many wrongdoing. There were even documents that were showing that he had hands in sharing, you know. This one is not even a Nigerian media, it's a German media, it's a German newspaper that published this, you know. But he came out and he denied all this allegation. You see, when you look at all what is happening, you will know that it was a setup. I think somebody is trying to do away with him. Yes, somebody in the Jubri government, that's how they do. They will use you when they get what they want, they will set you up and they will kick you out. You know, I think somebody is trying to set him up and expose his affairs to the public, something that the public is not supposed to see. So they did not only expose him, they also used for a way to sack him so that he will not have any diplomatic, any, you know, immunity to tackle this issue. So my brothers and sisters, what am I trying to say? I say the Jubri government, all these Fulani people, we only use and dump people. They only use and dump when they are done with you. This is what Nnamdi Kanu has been saying. If only these our leaders joined the Biafran fight, this would not happen. By now, we'll be very close to the finish, you know, the end of our race. Because now, our leaders know that we are very close. We are very close for our restoration. They know. But you see, when we are already close to our restoration and we don't even trust them again, all of them are falling. All of them are falling. When we begged them to come and join us, let us fight for a good cause. Because anybody born in the Southeast is a Biafran. You cannot deny this. You are a Biafran. Sooner or later, you realize, if you don't do it for yourself right now, how about your children's children? You see, we told them, they refused to listen to us. Now we are begging even the Southeast governors for them to join hands with us. Okay, the other time, after they have refused to apologize for what happened in the Southeast, what happened in Nnamdi Kanu's resident, the Operation Python dance that a lot of people died in, they refused to apologize. You know why they refused? They said they had no knowledge of what was going on, that what happened and the prescription of Biafran is done by the federal government and they had no hand in it. That all they did was to restrict the movements of Biafran in the land. They did not ban Biafra. They did not ban the indigenous people of Biafra. So they have no reason to apologize. Wow. Then after 1 or 2 days, they heard that our leader Nnamdi Kanu was invited to European Parliament. That's where everybody jumped again and was calling for a dialogue, which we rejected. So you see, right now we are begging them, we are telling them that we have a future in what we are doing. We are not just playing here, because when a man is sent by God to come and do something, it will definitely be done, because he has the backing of heaven, you know. So we told them, Biafra is of God. Because what is happening in Nigeria is not something that even God himself is proud of. You can see the killing, you can see the ritualists, you can see the corruption, you can see the immorality, you can see so many things happening, higher rate of prostitution, drug pushers, yahoo yahoo fraud, and many things happening in Nigeria right now. God is not proud of this. And we as a chosen nation don't want to be part of this. So we told these people that they should join this race. Let us fight together, hand in hand, chest with chest. Let's fight and conquer this corrupt government, this corrupt business enterprise called Nigeria. But because of their selfish nature, because of their selfishness, because of whatever that they are chasing, blinded them against the truth. Now, see what is happening. All of them are going down. All of them are going down. Immediately Buhari finishes using them, immediately Jubri finishes using them, he will take them all down because he does not need them to be very strong and powerful to challenge the Nigerian government. So you see, these people have an agenda. We already saw it. They have an agenda to destroy every Igbo man that becomes very powerful. Yes, they have an agenda to do that because they know what we can become when we are powerful. So they don't want us to get to that position. And these people don't know what is going on yet. They keep promising them presidency, which will never happen because we know that they don't want the Igbos to separate from Nigeria, because if they separate from Nigeria, Nigeria will collapse. They know it. They know it. So no matter what, they will try as much as possible to rather give it to the Southwest, to the Yorubas, the people that they know they can control, not we, the Igbos, that they can't control. Just go out and look around you. It's so transparent and visible for everybody to see. Can't you see the marginalization? Why do you think they put us in a cage? Because they know how powerful we can become. They know that if the land of Biafra come, we will be unstoppable worldwide. See the way our leader moves. Look at the way he moves and do his things. Very smart. Is that not how your president Jubri is supposed to be doing things? Diplomatically, getting involved, getting doing this and doing that, getting involved with the international bodies. Look at how Nnamdi Kanu moves. With a man with reputation, a man that will become a great man. Even India, look at India. India, that was one of the poorest countries in the world. Look at how powerful they are now. Yet, we keep declining. Look at ourselves. And yet, somebody will wake up and tell me about one Nigeria. What is one Nigeria? Let me ask you. What do you know about one Nigeria? A country that enslaves its own people? A country that embezzles all the money that is meant for project? A country that the politicians are getting richer and richer, and the people are getting poorer? A country where there is no middle class? It's either you are rich or you are extremely poor? A country that's so expensive that you don't even know why it's so expensive. Go to Lagos and see. You want to build a house? You need hundreds of millions. Is it supposed to be that way? Nigeria, Lagos is so expensive that even New York is standing by the side and watching them, you know. Because you don't know why you are paying this much for a house. In a country where we don't have 24 hours light. In a country where we don't have good medical health care. And you call this one a country? And you are telling me about one Nigeria? It's time for everybody to open their eyes and see Nigeria the way it is. Nigeria is a business entity. It's not a country. They don't care about us. They don't care about our welfare. They don't care about our future. They don't care about whatever goes on with us. If they care about us, they would have looked for a way to set up a very good medical health care in Nigeria so that we don't need to be traveling abroad to go for medical checkup or anything. If they care about us, they would have given us 24 hours light. 24 hours light so that we'll be able to run our businesses. It's because we can't run our businesses. That's why a lot of our brothers travel abroad and now they are being victim of circumstances. They don't care about us, my brothers and sisters. It's time for all of us to wake up. Wake up, wake up, and let us seek for our own right. Yes, division is the only solution to the Nigerian problem. Yes, there is nothing we can do about it. This is the truth. We have to divide and start all afresh in our different countries. Thank you.